I mentioned that XFS uses log-based striping in software. So let's understand that technology in a little bit more detail. You have clients on the local area network that are writing to files. When a client makes a change to a file, the changes that are made by this client to files are written to an append-only log. And this append-only log is a data structure. This log segment is a data structure in the memory of the client in the distributed file system. And this append-only data structure contains the changes made to files on this client node. And for instance, this could be a change for a particular file X. This could be the change for another file Z, and so on and so forth. And this is an append-only data structure that is residing at this client. Similarly, there is a log segment that is available at this client for the changes made to files on this node. And when this log segment fills up beyond a certain capacity, you decide on a certain threshold, and once that threshold number of fragments have been written into this log segment, then you decide that it's time now to write to the disk. So you take these log fragments and compute the parity, which is the checksum or ECC, whatever you may want to call it, and this becomes the log segment that I want to write to the disk. And you take this and stripe it across storage servers. So you take this particular log fragment along with its ECC and stripe it on storage servers so that it is now available on the storage system. And as I mentioned, you want to do this periodically in order to avoid the chance of data loss due to failures of a particular node. And that's what you're doing every periodically. Same thing is happening on this. So if you look at the storage server, you see that the storage server has the log segments that have been written by this client and the log segment that has been written by the log segment that has been written by this client. All of this gets into the storage servers. And the other thing that you want to do is you don't want every log segment to be written on all the disks available on the local area network. You don't want to do that. This is again concerned with solving the small write problem. And therefore, what we want to do is we want to subset the storage servers and say that if, let's say, I have 100 storage servers available on the local area network, I might decide that every log segment is going to write its log over a small fraction of that, maybe 10 servers. And this client may similarly choose a subset of storage servers to write it on. The subset of storage servers that is used for striping a given log segment is called a stripe group for that particular log segment.